Cheers and welcome, my friends. I'm Horath, and we are playing Europa Universalis IV together with the newest DLC, Rights of Man. We're playing on very hard difficulty with historical lucky nations. In the last episode, we took that gold province over here from Hungary. We're currently in the process of clearing them. We had to take that one as well, just so that we have connection. We also freed Silesia over there. They're pretty happy. And we are fighting Bohemia, Saxony, Anhalt, and Pomerania in a second war because I want them on a different truce timer. And the truce was just running out, so I had to attack them. There's a couple of things that I want to do, mainly flip the religions of these guys, just to get that done, because we have a lot of heretical princes and it's not good for the empire, so we got to change that. And there's no guarantee that they stay with the flipped religion that you gave them, but there's a good chance. And once we're done with that, we definitely have to use all our resources. Come on, Spain, you can do it. Yes, okay. So they should win this. That should be a stack wipe. Come on, wipe them. Yeah, they're gone. Good. I really like those Spanish soldiers. They look very stylish, I gotta say. Yeah, we're nearly done sieging this stuff down, so come on. Let's merge that army. Extend that loan. We're done with Stralsund. Let's just take all the cannons. Oh, it's only cannons. Okay, so then let's move them over. Or maybe we don't even have to do that. Maybe we don't have to siege them down fully to get what we want. We want you to become Catholic. No, they won't do it. Okay, 90, 218. Okay, so we're gonna do it. There's no way around it, I guess. Let's pull the infantry out. We don't need them. We only need the cannons. Okay, join these guys, split them in half, move them over. You're gonna get that leader, I guess. Good, that's looking good. We should be done with that one soonish. That's the Imperial Guard. And Bosnia is added again. Come on, Bosnia, just give up. Just give up. You're not gonna play a huge role in this. Prague is now the seat of a new cardinal. He's loyal to Bavaria. They have one active cardinal. Wasn't Munich a seat of a cardinal at some point? No, Munich can't be because it's reformed. Yes, right. Can only change that in 78. That pisses me off. Religious zeal. Annoying as hell. Well, come on. We're only waiting for this to end. With the maximum amount of cannons there, so it goes as fast as possible. Let's just bring my armies down. Yeah, they want peace now. Just wait a little bit. And they will start building mercenaries over there again. Which is not something I want. Regensburg has converted to Protestant. Come on. That's not good. There are the mercenaries that Pomerania hired from Burgundy. Let's split these guys. We're still not done coring those, which is not good. And we're done with Greifswald. Okay then, so let's move these guys to Prague. So, Pomerania, you're going to rejoin the one and only, the Catholic religion. Welcome back. We want war reparations. And we need some money. Okay, so 329 out of 444 and 10% of their income. That's fair enough, I think. So, thank you. We won't have to share that with anyone, because... that's good. Let's cancel the military access because we are paying for that in diplo points. Oh, and we have a revolt down there. We're done improving with them. Let's send our troops over there. That's not good. Nitran separatists. I put this down to Bohemia. I'm pretty sure that Bohemia is financing rebels in my lands. That's not good. I don't, really don't like those close battles. Don't think we'll be able to reach just yet. Now, Anhalt, what say you to giving me all your money, becoming Catholic and paying me war reparations? Also, don't be friends with Bohemia any longer. I don't want that. I don't want to leave them without any alliances, but yeah, I don't want them to be friends. They can have friends in Frankfurt, but having them clustered up is not good. So that's another Catholic prince. They are back to being good Catholics. I like it. Now, you guys, I can't take Saxony because that will give me a lot of aggressive expansion. I don't really need it. But the problem is they are too big for me to force their religion. That's not good. But I gotta go for war reparations. Give me some money. Maybe give up claims in Brandenburg. And I guess you're gonna annul your treaties with Bohemia. Hesse and Hamburg. You will have no longer any more allies. So that your warmongering days are over. Okay. And now to Bohemia. You are nearly completely done. I want you to become Catholic. Give me your money. You don't have much, but I take what you have. And I want to revoke cores. Stop your core in Oberlausitz. Stop your core in Ratibor. Return core. I could force them to give one more thing to Silesia. They would do it. I'm not sure it's going to help me though. I mean, I could take that place. I do have a claim on it. People won't be that crazed. And that would allow me to flip that center of reformation that's been bugging me so much. And they would be down to a one province minor. It's not a bad idea. It's not a bad idea. They're still very strong. They're still super strong. One in 23 aggressive expansion. A lot of the others won't care too much. Austria will care very much. It's only one province though. What about Poland? No. Poland won't care. Hessen, Switzerland, Memmingen, Mecklenburg, Augsburg. Most of these guys are already in a coalition, so I don't really have to care too much. Silesia won't be my friend anymore, though. Well, this should sort of stunlock them. This should prevent them from attacking each other. Otherwise, I can see Bohemia taking over Silesia over there again. Yeah, why not? Why not? I hadn't planned on taking more land, but it sort of makes sense. Because I can finally flip that frickin' center of reformation. I don't want that. Let's do it then. So we've got Glogau. That's gonna flip Brandenburg off, I think. No, they don't care. They want Neumark. They have sort of given up on their ambitions. Let's go for it then. Let's call that place. And it's already Catholic. So, oh. Yeah, I guess that always flips their capital, I think. Yeah, it flips their capital. Okay, that's good. So, I actually didn't really help them become Protestant. Due to the religious conversion of Glogar, the Protestant center of Reformation in the province has disappeared. That's perfect. That's perfect. I might not even want to core this. I could just sell it to Silesia. Well, I mean, it's a 17 development province, and I already took the aggressive expansion, so I might as well bring these guys down. So now we only have to care about Austria. I'm fine with having this little province, and we already have a fort next to it, so it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. We'll core it. Okay, we won that battle. That's good. We have some guys being built in there. Can I stop that? Oh no, stopped on its own. Good. Well, move all units to Prague. We'll sort of merge them, split them, and then we'll go after Austria and Savoy. We still need 6,000 men, so we're down to 30,000. It's not great. It's not great. Regrettably, we lost the conquest castle spell against Bohemia. Bohemia, yeah, they don't like us. We have the same religion, though. I mean, it might not be tenable to do that. But still, I think I'm going to try to improve relations with them. 13th of May. Let's go for it. They are one province elector now, which is fine. And they are no longer heretics. And that reduced the amount of imperial authority I lose by quite a bit. So I'm looking forward to doing that some more. They still like me. So let's split these two armies. I have the Imperial Guard, and this is going to be the... I don't know. The army of the crown prince again. I don't have a crown prince. Oh, do I? Yeah, I do have a crown prince, but he's only 8, so I might not want that. Okay, let's go after Austria now. They're over there. We're not getting anywhere over here with these battles. Why is Austria still fighting? Why are they still fighting? I could just try to separate piece Savoy out. They won't even be willing to take a white piece. Oh no, I'm asking for ban. Clear the offer. No, they're not willing to go for the white piece. Okay, they would. 23-15, which would allow me to fully concentrate on Austria. But I sort of want to take ban to flip that center of reformation, because they are not doing a very good job, and it's sort of pissing me off that we're getting that. At least that center of reformation is gone now. That's good. Didn't know that that would flip the capital, forcing them to be Catholic. And these guys are taking that one back, which means that I can be friends with Pomerania as well. So let's start improving with them. Magdeburg is Catholic. Anhalt is Catholic. Let's go for improved relations with them as well. Maybe I can do something. Bohemia have set Silesia as the rival. That's kind of to be expected. This eastern piece is about as good as I can expect. I would like to take that one and that one as well from Hungary, so that I can make that into a state. But other than that, things are going pretty well at the moment. How's my force limit? My force limit is 49. I might not want to increase my forces anymore. I still have difficulties doing stuff. I'm losing a lot of money as well, so... I guess what I might want to do... well, maybe not. But what I could do is actually start to hire one mercenary and make it so that armies can attach. So then I can sort of use the armies of my allies without having to suffer the attrition that causes. Let's repay that loan. End of religious turmoil. France hired some troops. These guys might not want to be my friends anymore with all the aggressive expansion. Yeah, they still would do it. 61. disloyal estates. Could ask them for some money, but that's not going to make them any happier. I could go for admin tech, which would give me more ideas. That's very expensive. It's very expensive. I do want the colonialism to spread into my land, but it doesn't really help me. I have no friendly countries around me. I just have to hope that it spreads into Brandenburg at some point. I mean, Cologne has embraced it, so they are friendly-ish. Yeah, I guess we gotta... I mean, they do have a breach in there, in Milan. So that might be good. Let's just hope that they stay there and don't run around like crazy. Like they always do. So I'm gonna allow friendlies to attach. I think I'm gonna take my best general for this, actually. Oh, well, no. France tends to have good generals. So... we're just gonna give these guys a normal general. And we allow friendlies to attach, so maybe someone will come and attach to us. If they siege down Milan, that's gonna be good. We're all on medium. The enemy is on low everywhere. This has been a very costly war, I think. Burgundy is no longer renting out their army to Pomerania. Oh, and Verden accepted a peace. We'll be forced to give Cologne 10% of their income. Verden will convert to Catholic. Nice. So Cologne is actually throwing their weight around to do some good deeds there. I like it. That sort of makes me think that they are not as bad as I would have thought. They're trying to convert their land. Let's hope they make it. Cologne embraced colonialism. That's good. It's also sort of a joke. Cologne embracing colonialism. Okay, so that French army has attached to me. So we'll try to siege down Canton. It's got to be done. It's got to be done. And I'd rather France suffers the manpower loss than I. Or me. Come on, I hope this works. Sort of need to make inroads versus Savoy at some point. Cologne is a rival now. Cologne no longer considers Liège as a rival. Yeah, but that Cologne and Brandenburg are rivals is not good. Oh, they detached. Just like that. Thanks for leaving me out in the cold, France. Thank you. It's not very nice. I mean, okay, if they smash that army over there, that's gonna be good. They're locked in now. Let's try to stop them from getting over there. Hussite traditions. Religion in Budweis changes to Protestant. That's not a problem. We'll just convert you. Oh, zero. Total missionary strength. Recent uprising. What? Why do we have the religious zeal even though there's no religious zeal anymore in that province? Okay, yeah. Now it works. So we're attacking these guys. I guess I should send my second army in there as well. Oh no, we won the Battle of Linz. Okay then. Stay in there. Doesn't really help when no one attaches to my armies. Okay, we got Milan though. That's good. That's definitely making Savoy a lot worse. So I've sieged that one down. Steiermark has come under our occupation. Let's go for Canton. Let's try if we can't do it. It's just very dangerous to siege down these mountain forts, but at least we have 9,000 now because Brandenburg has attached. So that shouldn't take forever. And if we get attacked, we might always be able to reinforce there. Man, I'm losing a lot of money. I already lost half of the money that I gained in that last war. There's the Burgundian army. Yeah, if we can take out Canton, the situation of Austria will become a lot more untenable. The growth of the printing industry, the ability to mass produce the written word, would revolutionize the spread of information and in many ways the early modern society as a whole. Pioneered by Renaissance men such as Venetian printer Aldus Manutius, the new art helped fuel the Renaissance by making the translated classics more widely available. Later, the Reformation benefited greatly from the ability to spread critical publications and translations of the Holy Scriptures. Now that printing has matured as a technique and spread throughout Europe, editions have grown and hundreds of thousands of copies of everything from religious and political pamphlets to instructions in how to behave or scientific treatises are circulating the continent. With print shops growing ever more commonplace, rulers have found it hard to contain the new technique as the comparatively easy means of production means censorship can be sidestepped by moving business across a border or even just changing the name on a title page. So we get another institution that we haven't embraced. But where did that one originate is my question. Let's have a look. So we got the printing press in Anhalt. Okay, yeah, I guess that's fair. How does that spread though? How does that spread? Let's have a look at Potsdam. Printing press. So state religion is Protestant or Reformed. Province is Protestant or Reformed. Nearby Flandrian province has printing press. Adjacent has printing press and loyal clergy present. European 20 development capital 0.07. Capital of country with diplotech 15.06. Okay, well, that should go towards me, I hope. Yeah, we're gaining it at 0.17, so at least we'll be able to get the printing press at some point. The colonialism has been a disaster so far. We're not getting anywhere here. And we're getting attrition by France again. Thank you, France, for having my men die. And you're coming back in. Stability increases. Our decision to give more power to local magnates has ensured that people of importance feel good about our government, so they have been telling everyone else how well they are being governed. Great, another stability. That's a lot of admin power that I'm getting gifted there. 16, 17, 9. Yeah, these guys still hate me. They hate my guts. I can't really blame them. I've sort of reduced them to one province minor from being the second biggest country in the HRE, so I guess it's just natural that they would be my mortal enemies. Why is France not sieging down Savoy? Come on, it's so easy. It's so easy. At least when we take that, we'll be able to smash the Austrian armies. Are we up too high again? Castile and France are still at medium, I guess because of the war exhaustion. But the enemy army strength is very low. Advancement of the clergy. The power of the clergy has never relied on the state itself. Rather, it is in many ways the clergy who, through their ties to the spiritual realm, lend their legitimacy to the emperor. A combination of deft political maneuvering, perceived bad omens, and generous donations from our subjects have lately cemented the power of this estate. They gain 10 influence. I don't have a problem with that. I don't have a problem with that at all. Oh, they're sieging my state down over there. That's not good. Austria. I guess France is on its way. Really looking forward to calling that stuff. When I'm done with Austria, I'm not going to take any more land. I let my aggressive expansion die down. At least I say that. Repay the loan, and we're down to nothing again. How much did that help? 2,000. I mean, I could buy down my inflation. That's certainly true. Why is Cologne not my friend? Why is Württemberg not my friend? They won't come into an alliance. Oh, they definitely would do it if they could. Okay, so that problem is gone. And we already breached the walls of this place. That's very good. So we're just going to wait until this one's done, because then the tables are also turned. We will get the defensive benefit of that fortress over there, We've taken another loan. Yeah, I guess that's the way of it. At least we can siege this down without using our own troops. And I'm looking very much forward to having my own gold mine over there. 0%. I hope they don't move in. We have the walls breached a second time, I guess. That can happen a couple of times. Breaching the walls gives a +3 bonus. Let's just hope they don't move in. We really need that siege. We lost the claim on Saxon, truce with Württemberg. Our good general died, because why wouldn't he? And we have Nuremberg separatists. Nope, Castile takes care of them. Yes, they do. Thanks, Castile. And these guys are attritioning themselves to death in their province over there. And when we're done sieging that one down, we will finally be able to get at them. Let's recall the diplomat from Anhalt. Saxony. They're still reformed. Austria hired the army from Memmingen. Move these guys over. Move these guys over. Neuhäusel is now our core. That's good. Austria is finally willing to make peace. Okay. Influential preacher. A young devout preacher has spoken out recently about how great our adherence to the teachings of the Holy Roman Holy Father in Rome is. This can only be good for our future. Ah, we already had 95 prestige. Yeah, let's gain the papal influence. Let's see what we can do. Papal blessing, indulgence for the sin. Yeah, our legitimacy isn't great. But it's growing rather fast. So I think we'll go for the papal legate to have more diplomatic reputation. Austria. What? They hired units from the Ottomans? Really? I mean, okay, I guess they have France as their rival. Finally, we're done with Canton. Which means that we might be able to make more moves on them. Yeah, let them come. Let them try to take Canton. Finally, the gold mine province is ours now. We only get 61. That one is reducing goods produced by 20%. We also have to bring up production, and they are not our own culture. They still have separatism. Could try to make them into a state, but I'd rather hold on to my admin points for now. Okay, there are more troops. Yeah, they're moving in. They're moving in to smash those guys. Finally, we're getting somewhere. Finally. Finally. Killing those armies. I mean, these guys are sieging that one down. Just as they please. Okay, we've got Krain. Friuli is already being defended by another fort. That is being defended by another fort. Austria has so many forts. What I would really like to do, what I would really like to see, is a war goal option or a peace treaty option that says destroy that fort. Take down that fort, because that has been something that's been done historically. I'm going to go for the war goal over there in Tyrol. I think that's going to be good. Guess I gotta give up on doing anything to Savoy, but doing stuff to Austria could still be nice. So we're down to nothing. So if I were to take Tyrol, and I would force you to bring out Aquileia, Ravensburg, and Styria, we would end up with 70. Which means that I could take some other stuff. I mean, I could force you to cancel that place as well. Because I don't want you to grow over there. But they might just get that alliance as well. So. So if I were not to cancel that subject, just break it out of you later. Instead, just take Linz. Then they would be separated in two. I think that might be worth it. That might be worth it. If I were to take Canton as well, they wouldn't accept it, but I could still do it with my war score. Or I could try to take... Oh, that's too expensive, I guess. If I were to take Ostmark, I could sort of fabricate on Wien. And I could immediately move on Wien. I think I should do this. That would hurt them a lot, because I would sort of gain a barrier where they could not move through, and I would have access to all that land, and I would have access to all that land. I can't do it right now, but I will be able to. 93%. Yeah, I think that might be the peace treaty that we're trying to gain over here. Releasing a bunch of land. Is that actually in the HRE? It isn't. It isn't. That's not good. That's not good. I might take this, add it to the HRE, and then do it. Is that a thing as well? If I were to not force you to release Aquileia, how much is Aquileia worth? Oh, Friuli. 11. So I should take that as well. And then I could add that as a state to the empire. So add the province. Yeah, I think that might be good. That would give me a lot of aggressive expansion with a lot of with a lot of countries, but it would smash Austria in two. It would absolutely smash them in two. I might not be able to be re-elected though. But I could always just try to vassalize that place. Could vassalize Aquileia. And we can always conquer those areas as well. Venice might conquer that. But sort of putting... getting all that land out of Austria might be a very good thing. Well, I guess that has to wait until the next episode. That has been a very long war. I do apologize for it. I sort of had to take care of Bohemia as well. I had to take care of Hungary and... sort of try to fulfill my duties as emperor, but we're getting there. So for now, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like. If you didn't, tell me why in the comments so I can improve. And if you want to see more of this series in the future, please consider subscribing to the channel. Hope you join me next time. Thanks and bye bye.